Hey guys, welcome to another video. So in this video we'll be talking about useful snippets you can use to just write the redundant code. Okay, so if you're a beginner to React, you must have found that writing some basic code to create new components for any application, you know, in application you may need multiple components, and for each component you must be creating some you must be writing some basic code to create those components. Okay, so there must be a lot of redundant code. Okay, I mean you don't have to write it again and again, so there must be an easy way to write all those code, those boilerplate code for components. That is why there is an extension provided by VS Code. What you have to do is head over to this extension section, and here you have to download this extension ES7 plus React Redux React Native Snippets. Okay, and after you install this, I have already installed it. After you install it, just restart your VS Code and you may see the effect of it. Okay, so let's see how it works. Okay, so there are some snippets. I'm going to show you some snippets. So first one is IMR. So as you can see, as I wrote IMR, and when I hit enter, it's going to automatically write this code, that is import React from React. Let's watch it again. Say IMR, just like this. Okay, so that's how IMR works. Now there are stages when you have to, you know, repeatedly write console log. For the console log, I'm just gonna write clg, and you can see the console.log appears, and you can write anything that you want here. Okay, anything. Next is we have multiples, and let's just say that you already have a module in mind and you have to import it. So I'm just gonna write imp. Okay, now you can write React here and React here, but suppose there is you have to import some other module, then you can use this snippet. Okay, now sometimes there are some destructuring import. Okay, you must have seen like import something destructured like useState. Okay, when we import useState, we used it like, we import it like this. Okay, that means it is destructured. That means we are directly importing that hook, okay, from that React module. So for this we use IMD, and if you want to import by destructuring, you can use IMD. Okay, now we come to the main part, that is how to, you know, use these snippets to easily write the component. Okay, how to easily create these React.js components. So for that there are several methods. Okay, so the main three are for the functional components. Okay, I'm not talking about the class type components, I'm just talking about functional components. So first one is RFC, React Functional Component. Okay, so it's a simple, pretty simple React Functional Component. Okay, second one is, so as you can see that we have declared a function and named it component one. Now this component one is would be same as the name of the file that you've created. I've created component one.js, so it's gonna create a component named component one, you know. Then the other method that you can use is rfce. So the difference between the previous one and this one is that it has a separate export default command at the bottom. Okay, so first it declared the component and then it exported it at the bottom. The last one is the functional component is in the form of an arrow function. Okay, how is that? Let's see. So you have to write RAFCE, and you can see that component one is an arrow function, and same it is exported at the bottom, this component. So that's how you can use these snippets to automate or auto write some of the boilerplate code, and it can be really productive and time saving. So thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.